In this section, I want to teach you all about color, applying color to your design. We'll start off with what the difference is between fill and stroke. So right now I have two stars in front of me. They're both gray. So that gray color is called the fill in Affinity Designer. And we'll go on to stroke afterwards, but how do we change this fill color? There's two locations. One is up here. You see it on the top left, it says fill. You can change it from there. And the second place is in the color tab on the right hand side. You see this circle here. If I just hover over it for a little bit, it will eventually pop up. See, it says set fill. So we can change it from both locations, but I will change it from the top left, okay? So I'm going to click on that. And now we're presented with this color wheel. Now, if you don't like color wheels, you can change it to any of these options, but I'm going to stick to this for now, okay? So we'll choose our color. I will make it some kind of yellow color. So from the outside, you choose the color. And then inside you can further customize how dark you want it or etc. So we're just going to keep it quite saturated for now. So that's our fill, okay? Now, what is stroke? Stroke is basically an outline. So if I head on up to stroke, which is right next to fill, and I click on that, and I'll just choose a color, maybe I'll just go black, okay? So it's black now. But you can't really see it, can you? It's very thin if it is there. So how we change the width of this outline, this stroke, is simply right next to it. You see where it says 1 pixel? That means it's 1 pixel width right now. So if I click on this and I slide it to the right, you can see it gets thicker. So basically, left is fill, right is stroke. And if we look up in the color tab, this circle here is fill. And if I click on the donut shape, that is our stroke. And there you can make your changes. Okay, also, if you do not want a fill or a stroke, you can simply go up to the color tab here. I don't want any fill on this. I can click on it and then I press set fill to none. And you see it has a little shortcut there. When you get more used to the program, you can start using that shortcut instead. So I'll just click on that. And now we have no fill. And to prove that, I will just drag it over this star. You can see straight through it.